บายเดวิดอเล็กซานเดอร์แอนด์มาร์กินีบริสวอชิงตันรอยเตอร์เพรสิเดนต์โดนัลด์ทรัมป์พิกเอนิวไฟออนเทอร์สเดวิดฮิสเซลโลรีพับลิกัน SAYIMGCOINGIESSIONALLEDHAVEDETAVEASIONGTETUDESDEBTCIELATHEDVICEDIANTATLANTIESTIANASTIANAMOFCIITICIESMOSTIANATICIEMOSFAIT Part A Budget and Review Infrastructure Trump sought to blame party lead the if Congress failed to agree to raise the cap on how much the federal government may borrow. The Treasury Department has said the ceiling must be raised by 29. If not, the government would be unable to borrow more money or pay its bill, including its debt payment. That could hurt the United States credit rating. Cause financial turmoil. SAYIMTATU.SDECONOMYANDPOSSIBLYTIGETATADAVISITDEVIETEDAEPUBLICAN They do it so now we have a big deal with them holding them up as usual on the T-Ceiling approval. Could have been so easy now a made from set in Twitter post.Recent media report suggests that Trump's relationship with McConnell has deteriorated amid repeated attacks by Trump on the Republican Senate Majority Leader for, among other things, failing to get a health care bill passed. The New York Times reported on Tuesday that McConnell and Trump were locked in a political cold war, especially after an off-air phone call that it said devolved into a shouting match.On the 9th and the 10th, Trump assailed McConnell via Twitter, anchored by a speech in which McConnell said Trump had excessive expectations of Congress. Trump swore and countered told for this week by the White House and McConnell office to play down report of discord. A spokesman for McConnell noted the Senate Majority Leader had said earlier this week, in an appearance with Treasury Secretary Steven Mnuchin, that the deputy ceiling would be raised. McConnell was unequivocal about it.Said spokesman Don Stewart, he said McConnell mentioned it again on Wednesday in a statement the Senate leader issued about his chat with Trump. Ryan, speaking at a town hall meeting on tax reform at a Boeing plant in Washington State, also said Congress would pass legislation to raise the ceiling in time to ensure debt payment. White House spokeswoman Sarah Sanders denied there was any need to repair the between Trump and top Republican lawmaker, fighting the relationship are fine.She told reporters, certainly there are going to be some policy difference, but there are also a lot of tackle and that what we're focused on. Deadline the debt ceiling is one of the matters major Congress will take up when it return on September 5. Congress will have about 12 working days from its return to approve spending measures to keep the government open, while the budget and debt cap are separate.They are likely to become entangled, with Republican opponents of a debt ceiling increase expect to demand federal spending cuts. Trump threatened on Tuesday to shut down the government if Congress failed to secure funding for his long-term promise wall along the U.S.-Mexican border. His tweet added a new wrinkle to the Republican months long struggle to reach a budget deal, rallying market and drawing rebuke from some Republican.Democrats, solidly opposed to funding the wall, have slammed Trump over his comments, both the spending and debt ceiling bill could pass the Republican-led House by a simple majority vote, but will need 60 votes to pass the Senate, where Republicans hold 52 of 100 seats, meaning they will need some Democratic support. A respecting tank said in a report on Thursday, the government may not have enough money to pay all its bill on October.2 if Washington does not raise the debt cap, the Treasury may not have enough money on that day to make a rally $80 billion payment that will be due to a military retirement fund. Particularly, if the leader of the party to replace Democratic former President Barack Obama to carry out something that Trump had promised to complete, the only problem I have with Mitch McConnell is that, after having replaced for 7 years, he felt that should never have happened, Trump said in a tweet on Thursday, echoing criticism he made earlier this month. McConnell offered muted criticism of Trump on Thursday, saying he was a little concerned about some of the trade rhetoric by the President, who has repeatedly condemned trade deals he believes are bad for the United States. And by other, trade is a winner for America, McConnell told Kentucky former and lawmaker. The assumption that every free trade agreement is a loser for America is largely untrue. Reporting by David Alexander, Margini Bryce, Susan Conwell, Steve Holland, David Morgan and Aya Rasko in Washington and Karen Bretel and Megan Davey in New York. Writing by Franz Curry and Achad Mohammed. Editing by Andrew Hay and Leslie Adler.